Ed, welcome back. Okay, so, as I said, we're gonna save Nanako today. But first, we're gonna gather up our party and go handle the bonus dungeon from, Naoto's secret base, Midnight Channel. And I'll just show off the boss there, and then finally we can move on to, the Heaven Dungeon. Again, fighting all these optional bosses at the end of each of these dungeons does play a key factor in fighting the secret boss in this game. But let's go ahead and just jump right to the boss, shall we? There we go. And hey, we're all in our Halloween costumes as well. Narukami is of course dressed as his vampire from the Halloween skit. Yosuke is a werewolf. Kanji is like Frankenstein, and Naoto is a cat girl, because of course she is. So this thing is weak to wind, which means this is Yosuke's game. This is why Yosuke is super useful to have. And also, while I was going through this dungeon, a lot of golden hands popped up, so my characters know quite a few new moves, and Naoto is actually leveled up quite a bit. In fact, she has way more SP than any of my other characters. She has a move called Makakarn and Tetrakarn, which are magical and physical reflect barriers, respectively. And also, if you just notice, Naoto also has access to Almighty-based skills, which is very useful. A little costly, but very useful. And as you also notice, Kanji now has my favorite physical move in the game, which is Primal Force. Narukami's still on debuff duty, though. So, Naoto kind of has an even mix of almighty spells and high damage attacks. Problem is, she does have quite a bit of SP, but a lot of her moves are very costly. And this is why I really like Primal Force. Because it does a ton of damage. Especially when it's paired up with Rakunda and Power Charge. Yeah, so Izanagi in terms of moves, even though it got a crit right here, is still kind of lagging behind a lot of my other characters' personas. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and switch off to my personal Izanagi after this dungeon to just kind of clean up the bonus boss here once we save Nanako. I mean, and then I guess we'll just fight the secret boss, because I guess this is it. I mean, we caught the killer, or at least we cornered him. So yeah, now my new strategy for Kanji is Power Charge, have Narukami Rakunda the hell out of the enemy, and then Primal Force. Naoto also has single target Dain level spells. She gets Agi Dain, Bufu Dain, and Garu Dain. She starts off with Garu and Agi, but I got rid of Gyarudyne because Yosuke's already my wind guy, and I'm gonna have him in my party for the majority of the game, if not the entirety of the game. So I figured, okay, I'm taking Yukiko out, so I may as well have at least one character who can use fire techniques. That's not Narukami. She's kind of like the jack of all trades. She's like the female equivalent of Yosuke in terms of being a jack of all trades. Yeah, and as I mentioned in the last episode, all that food and all that stuff we got from Tanaka, there is no healing items that can be used in battle. So I had to go to the item shop in order to buy some more of those, because also, as I mentioned in the last episode, I do break my rule of only using Izanagi, I do switch to two different personas in this episode. And that's mainly because I was put into kind of a corner, and I didn't have any really good healing items at the time. But we'll get to there whenever we get there. This bonus boss isn't that difficult, especially if you've been grinding as much as I have, if not more so. And also if you just abuse his wind weakness. It ain't going down. Yeah, and I just had the one wind damage item. Just wanted to abuse his wind weakness. But Narukami can just whack it with his sword. There you go. And Narukami just like... works with the cape. He's really embracing the whole vampire thing. Yes, I leveled up. Some characters do have unique poses for certain costumes, as we'll soon see. And there you go. Like with most of the bonus bosses, you get a new weapon for one of your characters. It's certainly not nearly as good as the gun I have Naoto currently equipped with. Alright, so let's go ahead and go save Nanako at the Pearly Gates. And now it's playing one of the calmer dungeon themes. This is Heaven. It's very relaxing, and also this dungeon is very inviting, I suppose. Despite the fact that Nanako is in severe danger, this place looks pretty nice. And as you've probably noticed, my characters are now in their Gekkoukan High costumes. Again, you need to talk to Kashiwagi after you visit Tatsumi Port Island. I believe you have to get top marks on the tests in order to get these costumes as well. But as long as you've been either following the guide or a walkthrough online, it shouldn't be that hard. And look, Naoto is actually in a dress for once. Just say the word and it's go time. Have at it. Now each of these each of your characters quotes their respective counterpart from Persona 3. Narukami, since neither he nor Minato Arisato, the protagonist from Persona 3, don't talk. They just copy each other's poses. And I hope that carries over to Persona 5 as well. But Kanji quotes Akihiko, Yosuke quotes Junpei, and Naoto, in this case, I believe she quotes Aigis. Strangely enough. Although they both were the ones who used firearms. I believe Chie quotes Yukari. Teddy, I think, quotes Ken. And I'm not sure who Yukiko... Oh, no. I think... Yeah, Yukiko quotes Mitsuru. So, yeah, they didn't have anybody for Koromaru. Be a little weird just having, I guess it'd be Teddy, probably. Be a little weird for having one of your characters just bark. Ah, well. Now, this dungeon is very straightforward. It's just a straight shot up to, I believe, the 10th floor. I believe this dungeon has 10 floors. So, we're just gonna go ahead and speed it up a little bit. I mean, this does seem like a dungeon that Nanako would create, and I'm not entirely sure of what a Shadow Nanako would play out. This just seems to be like a rescue mission, because Nanako herself did not fully appear on the Midnight Channel. I mean, a shadow of herself did, but I don't really see what kind of, like, what her shadow version of herself would be. So we're getting close. Again, this dungeon is a very straight shot up to the 10th floor. And it's kind of nice that this dungeon doesn't have too many weird gimmicks like the previous two dungeons. But first, cutscene. Yeah.
That's Nana-chan's voice.
Mom, where are you? Why did you disappear? Why did you leave me?
Yeah.
No. Come back.
Is that really a part of yourself that you should be ashamed of? Like, how can you translate that to a shadow?
I'm not lonely. I have Dad with me. I know he's always late coming home. And he never plays with me because he's so busy. He can't cook or do laundry either. He tries to be nice, though he is a little scary sometimes. But I love
him.
Big Bro is with me now too. So I'm not alone. I'm not lonely.
Little kid. Telling herself she's not lonely so she doesn't fall apart.
You idiot. We'll ruin everything if we act
all sad. I gotta put on a happy face.
With a smile.
I like Yosuke's optimism here. We're gonna go save her, so we all gotta be super happy when we see her.
What's the matter? Something's not right. There's someone here besides Nanako.
Yeah, it's nothing's ever easy, is it?
I fainted first, so I couldn't tell for sure. But there's definitely another person here. And whoever this is, their power's getting stronger.
Could it be Namatame?
Of course it is.
Cornered like Mitsuo?
Perhaps so. It seemed as if he was particularly determined to kidnap Nanako.
That's not great.
But why? If he's the real culprit, he must know the dangers of coming into this world. I don't know.
Maybe he thought it'd be better than being caught by the police?
Near the site of the accident. Perhaps even the TV in his truck. Which means Nanako-chan may be in grave danger. We must hurry.
So yeah, gotta get the lead out. Gotta save Nanako right now. Right now? Right now. I put this off for a few days in the previous episode, but now we gotta save her right now. Right now. Oh, man. As if the stakes weren't high enough. Because you do not want to get that game over message for waiting too long to save Nanako. You do not want that. That one's especially rough. Oof. So yeah, apparently Namatame's here. So, can you guess who the boss is? Here's a spoiler. Nanako doesn't have a shadow. Because... what? What's her shadow supposed to be of? She's a small little child who doesn't really... who kind of just speaks her mind. You know? There's not exactly a lot of... repressed feelings that would manifest themselves as a shadow. And if it wasn't obvious, yeah, Namatame's here. And he's drowning out Nanako's presence, so we gotta go kick his ass right now. This dungeon, man. This dungeon. It's a quick one, but... It doesn't need any gimmicks. That's the whole point of this dungeon. It's relaxing and yet unsettling at the same time, because of who the victim is right now. This is the worst case scenario. Because the dungeon is heaven, and Nanako has been kidnapped by our serial killer. So overall, this is just not a very... This isn't great. Although, you gotta think, if Namatame is here, shouldn't his, like, vision, shouldn't his, like, feelings be influencing the dungeon as well? I mean, it's just, like, the heaven thing is pretty obvious for Nanako because she misses her mom. And that's kind of why this dungeon doesn't feel entirely oppressive, because it's not really oppressive. It's just kind of like her version of a storybook version of heaven. But my whole thing is, I was kind of expecting sort of a Psychonauts final area vibe, like where it's two people's visions of this, like two people's separate visions, like meshing into some kind of horrible amalgamation. Like it has Nanako's vision of heaven and Namatame's, I don't know, his serial killing stuff, or Although, to be fair, Namatame did mention the word save a lot. And that does play a bit of a key factor into this. See, there you go. I must save people. So maybe he has somewhat of a messiah complex. Maybe he has something of a savior slash messiah complex. And that's kind of how this relates to this dungeon. It's going to be very obvious when we actually get to the final floor of this dungeon. Now, you might think this shadow's just kind of a throwaway enemy, but look closely at what that is. It's a scale. It's the scales of justice. Kind of like, I don't know, Nanako's social link? Also, Yosuke learned Brave Blade, which is a pretty good physical attack. And it does some pretty good damage. Not nearly as good as Primal Force, but hey, Yosuke is not our main physical attacker.
One enemy to go. Keep it up.
Come on down. Soda.
I just recently learned all the arcanas that our party members in Persona 5 have. Well, with the exception of Goro, but I imagine he's probably, Wheel of Fortune? Maybe? I'm not entirely sure. No, he's not Wheel of Fortune, because I think somebody else is Fortune. So, of course, our main protagonist is the Fool, so that's just like Narukami and Arisato. Our friend character, who's supposed to be like Yosuke, Ryuji, is actually, Chariot. So he's like Chie. Then we have Anne, and she is Lovers. So it's not that just that she looks kind of similar to Rise, she also has the same arcana. Morgana is actually, the little small anime cat thing, is actually the magician. Yusuke, who is the fox, he is actually the emperor arcana. So that's pretty cool. That's our another kanji. Maybe not. My favorite girl so far, Makoto, she's actually the priestess, which that seems weird considering she's all about justice. Futaba, the other really cool girl character, is the hermit, but I think I mentioned that already. And then we have Haru, who is the empress. Been a while since we've had a party member who is the empress. I think it was Mitsuru who was the last one. And then Goro, who apparently is called the Crow. He hasn't had his arcana revealed just yet. So yeah, Namatame's kind of a little going crazy. Yeah, that's not good. That's super not good. That is super not good. Need to save her now. Gotta go now. Whew. The stakes just keep getting raised. So I might actually do Persona 5 as a playthrough someday, eventually. Not right when it comes out, no. I want to do another New Game Plus for Persona 5 if I end up doing that series. But the real question is, which waifu do you want? That's the real important question. Is it going to be Anne? Is it going to be Haru? Is it going to be Makoto? Or maybe Futaba? Who knows? I don't know. I kind of have a soft... I like them all. They're all really good characters. Although, I kind of have a soft spot for Makoto. She rides a motorcycle persona, she uses revolvers, and she uses like, freaking gauntlets. That's just cool. I don't know. I got a soft spot for Makoto. She just seems really cool. And Anne's pretty cool as well. Haru, I need to know more. She seems, like, very haughty. Haru seems more like Karen from Street Fighter. I don't know. But enough about that. It's time to go ahead and save Nanako. Time to save Nanako, and this is not good. This is super not good. Nanako, I know this is against your, you know, natural inclination, but just punch him in the nuts. Just elbow him right in the crotch. Bam! And then run.
It's definitely him. Then he did come in here.
So you're the killer.
Let go of her!
Okay, I know this might seem a little grim. Nanako is quite a bit shorter than Namatame. So all Naoto has to do is just aim her gun a little bit above Nanako's head and then just shoot Namatame in the face. Then we save Nanako. Oh, but then in that case, Nanako would be scarred for life. Not like this is any better, but still. In a hostage situation, shoot the hostage. No, not Nanako. Choose your words carefully. You have to choose all three of these options.
To save
them. At least he's not choking her as much.
People needing to be saved appear. That's why I put them in the TV.
So Namatame's mentally gone bye-bye.
No, we must pull his attention away from Nanako-chan. You put the people you saw on the Midnight Channel into this world, am I correct?
They all want to be saved.
Did I ever ask you to save me?
Yeah, good point. Did she ever come out and say that?
Damn it! It was the exact opposite!
We had to fight shadows!
I hadn't put you in the TV.
We had to go to a hot... We had to go to a sauna with Kanji, who was half naked.
How would we? Are you trying to say we wouldn't have been able to face ourselves? What? But we nearly died!
It wasn't great.
Yes. Exactly.
You kidnapped them. Yes or no?
Yes.
Why did you target local residents who became known through the media? Why do these people appear on the Midnight Channel?
On rainy nights, on TV, they signal me to save them.
Yeah, it's probably not that great to just keep on talking. I don't think he's really going to have that much coherent shit to say.
Murder? No. I'm saving them.
How's that different, huh? All you're doing is killing people!
If you want to think that, go ahead. I know. You chased us all the way here to kill.
No. Nanako is... You are literally choking her. She's clearly not into this.
You're not gonna get away with this!
shut the hell up!
What a wonderful world.
Well, this is new.
Unknown, unreachable.
I think Namatame just turned into his shadow.
I'm a savior.
Hey, he does have a messiah complex.
So many evildoers.
That's why I'm going to save them. I'm a savior, a righteous hero.
Is that a shadow?
This is new. He just turned into a shadow. But he's also choking the hell out of Nanako, so maybe we should do something now.
Nana-chan! Let's do this.
Why didn't we do this earlier? Like, right when we saw him, just deck him.
Nana-chan.
Good thing we got our healers on standby.
Nanako-chan! Bastard! How dare you!
Quick, punch him in the dick. And now it's time for another animated cutscene. Hey, he lost his hat. Oh, okay.
What's happening to him?
That doesn't seem great. I love how Teddy's mouth doesn't move in the bear suit. How about me, Kanji, Yosuke, and Naoto handle this and the rest of you leave? Get Nanako out of here.
What is
this? It's symbolic.
Damn it. We've come this far. We're not losing now.
You know, the Jesus persona in Persona 3 was a lot cooler than this. So yeah. That Messiah complex thing wasn't too far off the mark. Love and peace forever. Oh my god, it's Agito! Okay.
I'm going to save her! Don't interfere!
How solid is his grasp on reality?
Not very. I'm gonna go ahead and say not very. Kunino Sugiri. Yeah, this guy is kind of a dick. A pretty straightforward boss, but he does have a very nasty gimmick toward the end of it.
Counting on you.
So, buff your characters. Rakunda, Makakarn, and Masakuja. And also Power Charge and then Primal Force his ass all day long. Always buff your characters. Make sure they are all at prime condition. Now, what happened in the anime was really super cool. Like, Narukami goes in and he summons Koryu to save Nanako and, like, fight off Kunino Sugiri. And then it's clear, like Namatame is, like, recognizing Koryu. And then Nanako is kind of, like, waking up and she sees Koryu and she's like, oh my god, it's dad. And it's so cool. And Koryu's so badass. Oh, it's a good scene. It's a good scene. I like it.
Come on down.
Thanks.
Come on down!
Now, I kind of like to keep Makakarn up on Naoto a lot, if only because it makes him waste a turn. And Makakarn doesn't really cost that much SP, and the fact that it makes him waste a turn is also pretty useful. Just keep lowering his defenses and keep power charging, and then just keep hammering him on with Primal Force and every other strong hitting ability you have. Risei's buffing skills that were added to the Golden really make a lot of these boss fights a lot easier. I kind of handicapped myself in this fight, considering the only character on our team who has any kind of healing naturally is Yosuke. And right now all he has is a single target heal spell. Which is not great. Now, Quad Converge actually improves elemental, will buff a certain element. Now, you won't know what it is until he hits you with it. In this case, it's ice, which none of my characters know. And see, Makakarn works really well considering it can just reflect one magical spell. And since he used a Ma spell, he was going to get hit with it one way or another. Which is why I try to keep Makakarn on at most times. Yeah, Diorama is the only heal spell that we have really at our disposal, besides a few lifestones. You want to keep Kanji pretty healed up, because he can't use Primal Force without enough health. And that's really been the most hard-hitting attack that I have at my disposal right now. Yeah, I did not have any. I was looking desperately for some mass healing items. I'm gonna buy some healing items at the item store before I do any more dungeon crawling. And now here comes Kunihime no Sagiri's worst move, Control, where he controls all your party members. I kind of skipped the part where he only controls one at a time, but now he has everybody. So that's not great. And hey, they're all targeting Narukami, and guess what? Narukami still has his wind weakness. Which, guess who happens to have Garudine? Good thing I blocked, otherwise that could have ended the battle right there. And hey, all my teammates are super badass. It's a good thing Kanji did not attack. So here's where I break my rule. Because if I didn't, I would have lost this match. I would have lost this match very hard. So, Skakath. Thanks, Yukiko. Even with this, I'm still kind of cutting it close. Because, oh yeah, my characters have in-game weapons too. And their personas are super badass. And of course, Risei had to increase all their attack power. Which is not great. Thank goodness they break free after about a turn or two. So now, Lakshmi. Thanks, Marie. Again, I break this rule once. This is the only time I use these personas. But I was kind of in between a rock and a hard place. I kind of had to do something, otherwise, you know. So I had to break my Izanagi only rule. But again, if you want, you can outfit Izanagi with a healing spell. So, and honestly, I should have bought more healing. I should have bought healing items before this dungeon. And maybe I should have kept Yukiko on my team. Of course, that wouldn't have done much, considering she would have been under the control thing too. And now, finally, after he does control a few times, he'll just use Unerring Justice for the rest of the fight. Which does some pretty decent damage. And he'll do that every turn until he wipes you. So now it's just a damage race. Besides that one little scary moment where your party members turn on you, this fight isn't really that difficult. As long as you can keep Narukami alive, everything else is fine. So just hammer him. Again and again and again. Just hammer him until he's dead. Although I guess the whole controlling your teammates thing works for Namatame's shadow. He does have a messiah complex, and I suppose cult of personality. A messiah can be very convincing, especially if people believe. But yay, we beat Namatame and saved Nanako. But we still gotta get her out of the TV world first, before we can call this a mission complete.
Damn it. Why?
Punch him in his face. That's good too, I guess.
She looks like she's in pain, but she doesn't seem to be injured anywhere.
Considering everybody else who's been in here is kind of been exhausted after they get their persona, yeah, that's not hard to believe. And then Narukami just leaves him behind.
We should take him with us as well.
Do we have to?
Yeah, we can't just leave him here, I guess.
We could. I mean, he kidnapped Nanako. Nah, that wouldn't be the correct thing to do. We can't be dicks. Otherwise, we'd be doing what Namatame was doing.
Nanako-chan, hang in there.
Why didn't we use any healing magic while we were in there?
She's so small, and she was stuck in there for so long, and then there was that weird fog. Damn it!
The police and paramedics will be here shortly.
Case closed? I guess? There's a little bit of, you know, silver lining to this.
Nana-chan still small, so her other self didn't appear like everyone else. And she got caught in all that craziness. I hope she'll be okay.
I mean, are the doctors going to be able to help her?
I'm worried about Nana-chan!
But there's nothing more we can do for her.
At least we got her out. That's a plus, right?
The possibility of Nanako-chan being targeted. If only I'd been more thorough in putting the facts together, then Nanako-chan wouldn't have had to go through this.
That goes for me too. If I hadn't stood there like a lump in front of that bastard, Nanako-chan might have been okay.
I hate myself. Why do I always panic when it matters most?
I couldn't do anything either.
I should have noticed sooner that something was wrong with that guy.
Why did I waste time listening to what Namatame had to say? If I hadn't tried to engage him in conversation, and we'd rescued Nanako-chan immediately, this wouldn't have happened.
It's no one's fault. It's all Namatame's fault.
All right. Enough of this pity party.
Is standing around and whining really what we ought to be doing now?
Love you, Kanji.
Consoling each other? That gonna solve anything?
Yeah.
You gotta believe in her. So stop rehashing what's already done. Get it together, Naoto.
I love you, Kanji. You're so cool.
Sorry.
Kanji's the best. Right. See, a lot of the time they make Yosuke seem like kind of the proxy for, they make Yosuke essentially the talk for Narukami.
Yeah.
But Kanji's the one who's getting shit done.
I'll come see Nana-chan.
Kanji's the really cool one who's like given the pep talks and given the huge heroic speeches.
Gee, Kanji, you sounded cool for a second.
That's why Kanji's my real second in command. That's why I love Kanji. He's so cool. He gets the most character development out of this entire game. Even more so than Narukami or Yosuke. And whenever the chips are down, Kanji's the one who's making the hard decisions. Because that's what it means to be a man.
Not just Nanako-chan, but the perp too. Who knows when we'll be able to hear his story. Well, it's getting late, so hurry home. The last thing we need is for you guys to collapse too.
He's right. We should call it a night. Nanako-chan's gonna be fine. Acting all gloomy won't help anything.
When Nanako-chan's out of the hospital, what should we do to celebrate?
Dude, isn't it a little early for that?
Well, we gotta think positive.
And have a party there.
A party at Juness? That makes no sense.
Do you know Nanako at all? That's like her favorite place ever. Gonna buy her a badass kotatsu.
Nana-chan, she'll get better, right?
Of course she is. Of course she's gonna get better. Nothing can keep her down.
Let's all have fun with Nana-chan when she comes back.
Yeah. So all we can really do is just wait for Nanako to recover. Rank 9 with Teddy. Almost done with the Fool and the Star Arcana. Getting close. Getting close.
Thanks. I almost forgot how to keep a happy face. But with that out of the way, I'm feeling all hungry. Hey! Where did everyone go? Don't leave without me!
And now it's time for another Persona 4 Golden exclusive scene. Normally the scene would end right there and we move on to the next day, but instead, we have another scene exclusive for the Golden version.
Huh? You didn't go home yet?
Hey, Dojima.
I heard. Thanks.
Yay. Everything turned out okay.
Long ago. I'm so relieved.
Dojima-san? You awake? I guess it's no surprise. He was so stressed out over Nanako-chan.
That's fair.
I'll stay with him tonight.
Aww.
Go home and rest, even if it's just for a little while.
I'm fine. I can deal with this all night.
Oh, please. You look terrible. Nanako-chan's safe, so relax. I think you should get some rest.
Aw, see? I thought you can be a cool guy sometimes. He's just looking out for you and Dojima. Been a while since we have upgraded the gesture arcana. I think this doesn't play out if you haven't been doing Adachi's social link. But hey! Cool, we got up a little closer with Adachi.
Friends are waiting, aren't they?
Adachi can be a cool guy when he wants to be. Yeah, let's go ahead and save this. Oof. We had a rough day today. Alright, I guess in the next update we'll do some more social links. And just wait for Nanako to recover. Still gotta go to school though. Ah well. Alright, Until then, thank you for watching.